Dallas, it was meaningless for me. In the three games prior, Tampa Bay's only allowing 3.5 yards per carry. Defense has also forced 7 turnovers. And since week 12, the Cowboys have had at least 1 turnover. In fact, they're averaging 2 a game on offense. You have got to be able to get first downs and to be able to honestly close out football games. That's where they, you know, the second half of the year, you would think this team was set up to be able to close you out, right? How do you close out football games in the NFL? You have a good pass rush, and you can run the ball and run out the clock. That has not been the case the last half of the year.
It hasn't, and it's really hard to fathom, especially after how the season started off. It felt, I was going through some of the highlights just last night, the first, I think, 6 games, especially with Cooper Rush. It felt like that defense was, you know, the strongest it's been in recent memory. It felt like the turnovers were plenty. It felt like the pass rush was getting home. You know, you sit there and you look at the Cowboys, you know, team highlights, and you just scroll down the play-by-play chart, and you see, you know, one-yard gain, sack, you know, strip sack, you have interception, like everything. It's just littered throughout the game chart. You just see big plays being made on defense, and then you talk about closing out the game with the run game. It feels like, especially against the Jacksonville's, against the Texans, you know, those kind of games, you don't even have the opportunity because the defense is letting these offenses stay in the game, so you don't get to have the luxury of even attempting to run the clock out when you're playing from behind. So this is, and you mentioned, this is not the team that you want to get into any kind of fourth quarter battle with in the Tampa Bay Buccaneers.
Not with 12.
Yeah, 12 is the king of the 2-minute drill. So I want to stay away from that as far as possible. And this is a team, luckily in Tampa Bay, that they have the same issue with the run game. They will not be able to run out that clock against you either.
They don't even try it.
Yeah,
it's funny, like, what are the left touches like? Y'all act like we were this great running offense last year, the year before. No, we were not. Good point being made here on the truckrock.com fan text. Total 4940 on the 7 games of Keith Hicks and Villa have played. They have given up the second fewest yards per carry. They're also 6-1 in those games. Good point there. Now, looking at some of the greatest assets for the Cowboys going into this game now, we mentioned the offensive, the turnovers. Well, the defense is causing them to. In the last 6 weeks, they're averaging almost 3 turnovers a game. Also, the offense, they've converted at least 20 first downs in every single game since mid-October until last week. The only teams with more first downs in games during that period, Kansas City and Detroit. I'm hoping that we can just throw out last week as
I think you can. That's the hope. And that's where my mind is at right now, especially. I feel like that's just an outlier. And I believe you mentioned this in a previous segment. It seems like this team, and especially number 4, he doesn't really allow back-to-back games to be, you know, similar in terms of the negative aspects of the game. He never really has bad back-to-back games.
And he plays well in the playoffs, by the way.
Yeah, he does. You know, the wins are going to be the imperative thing that's going to be brought up. Oh, well, how many rings does he have? Oh, how many playoff wins does he have? He plays pretty well.
Completion percentage, which is not high, but 6 touchdowns, 3 interceptions, an 87.9 passer rating at 7 yards per attempt. It's pretty good. You also have some good postseason experience just from guys that have come in. T.Y. Hilton, 9 games. Dante Fowler, you know, 6. Jason Peters, 6, you know, depending on, you know, how much we see them. They do have a lot, and this is another element, too. Injuries at key spots have directly impacted the Cowboys. Dallas is getting some back. That is absolutely correct. Leighton Van Der Esch and Tyler Biadasz, while it may not show up, so to speak, in the stat sheet, Tuesday morning, their impact of being on the field should be really, really big for this team. And Tampa Bay, this is what I was getting to, they're the eighth team to play a postseason game with a losing record. Those teams in the seven previous games were 2-5. The only wins by those teams came back in 2011 when Seattle beat New Orleans. You may remember that game was the Marshawn Lynch 67-yard touchdown run that felt like an earthquake, apparently, at the link. And in 2014, the Carolina Panthers defeated the Arizona Cardinals. Cam Newton now in Arizona that year. They were starting the wild card with their third-string quarterback, Ryan Lindley. So it doesn't happen very often, and it should not happen Monday night.
It shouldn't. And you mentioned, I'm going to go back to the key injuries. You've got some returning players here. One thing that I've been saying since you went down late with Van Der Esch, this defense has missed him.
Could you believe that you would feel that way after last year?
No,
I couldn't.
No, not at all. When you go out and you boldly say, we're going to decline your fifth-year option, that usually is very telling of, one, how a team feels about a player, but two, how that player is performing in the grand scheme of things, because those rookie deals, including the fifth-year option, are always going to be the cheapest way to keep a player around for a good amount of time and to give you that chance to keep them around for longer. Leighton Van Der Esch did not play that great last season. Everyone was coming for his neck. Every single game, it seemed like there was one play that you could point at and say, LVE was the mark on this play, missed tackle.
Yeah, and I was, Alec, if that would be something Monday night too. Listen to G-Bag this week, and Brian Broaddus has, like, you know, six different shows that he does. Yes, there's Love of the Star podcast with Bobby Belt. He also does one with the peeps over at .com, and Amber Garcia was one of them, because I heard Brian talking about, yeah, having Leighton back, it's going to be great, but to what degree, like, how confident is he in being able to, you know, hit, you know, with the neck, and is it a worry that he may not last in a game because of that?
I think you do have to have cautious optimism there, because it is a legit concern when you're talking about a shoulder and a neck issue. When you talk about nerve injuries that have plagued him in the past, it's absolutely a thing. But this guy, it's one of my favorite terms that comes up in draft season. He feels like one of those high-motor guys that is going to give it his all, and he's going to play the same fundamental football no matter how he's feeling. And at the same time, I do think it's...